Let's look into deriving the mean and variance of the sampling distribution of the sample mean X bar. We're going to let X1 through XN be N independently drawn observations from a distribution with mean mu and variance sigma squared. So if a random variable X is drawn from this distribution, the expectation of X is mu, and the variance of X is sigma squared. We're going to let X bar be a random variable representing the sample mean of these N independent observations. X bar is simply their sum over N. Now let's look into deriving the mean and variance of X bar here. We need the expectation of X bar, and that is the expectation of X1 plus X2 plus XN over N. Now, properties of expectation that we have discussed earlier, we can take this constant outside of the expectation and say that this is equal to 1 over N times the expectation of the sum of X1 through XN. And now, the expectation of the sum is always just the sum of the expectations. So this is 1 over N times the expectation of X1 plus expectation of X2 plus all the way up through XN. The expectation of the sum is the sum of the expectations. Now this is 1 over N times, what are the expectations here? Well, we're drawing from a distribution with mean mu and variance sigma squared. The expectation for each one of these terms is simply mu. So we have mu plus mu plus mu, N times. And so this is just 1 over N times N mu, which is simply mu. So the expectation of X bar is equal to mu. On average, the sample mean equals the population mean. What about the variance? The variance of X bar is equal to the variance of X1 plus X2 plus through XN over N. Now, when we multiply by a constant, the variance gets multiplied by that constant squared. So we can draw this N term out, but we have to square it. So this is equal to 1 over N squared times the variance of the sum. This is equal to 1 over N squared. Now we need the variance of the sum, which is the sum of the variances if these terms are independent, if X1 through XN are independent, and we've assumed them to be that here. So this is 1 over N squared times the variance of X1 plus the variance of X2 plus the variance of XN, and we're allowed to do that because those terms are independent. Now we have 1 over N squared times, what's the variance of X1? What's the variance of X2? These are all drawn from a distribution with variance sigma squared. So 1 over N squared times sigma squared plus sigma squared, and there's N of those. So this is 1 over N squared times N sigma squared, which is equal to sigma squared over N. So what we have found out is that the variance of X bar is equal to sigma squared over N. In other words, in different notation, sigma squared X bar, just different notation, the variance of X bar is equal to sigma squared over N, and the standard deviation of X bar is equal to the square root of the variance, which is just sigma over the square root of N. The standard deviation of X bar is equal to sigma over the square root of N. Now what have we just shown? We've shown that the mean of the sampling distribution of the sample mean is equal to the population mean, and we can write that as the expectation of X bar is equal to mu, or another way of writing that is that the mean of X bar is equal to mu. And we've shown that the standard deviation of the sampling distribution of X bar, sigma X bar, is equal to sigma over the square root of N. And we're going to use that in a few different places in the future.